Welcome to the Pool Solutions DIY help videos. In these videos we will help you to restore your swimming pool to look like the one you can see on in these pictures. And of course this is what the swimming pool looked like before. We will use P16 fiber grinding discs mounted on a rubber backing disc to a 230mm grinder to prepare the surface and remove all old paint, algae, any loose material brittleness from the surface and clean the surface in order to allow the primer layer to sufficiently penetrate into the plaster surface. We do not recommend using an acid wash or using chemicals to prepare the surface due to the fact that acid will penetrate into the surface and need to be neutralized very thoroughly afterwards, and this will create extra work for you, and if not done properly might create staining of the paint layer afterwards due to the reaction between acid or chemicals and the wet paint. We will just slightly grind the pool like this in preparation. Grit sandpaper. We will now start with the top coat, the first top coat layer, and as you can see we will be using top coat A mixed with top coat part B. First stir the contents of the top coat part A separately before adding the curing agent to the part A. Here we will measure out a certain amount, and we will measure out it in a 2-to-1 mix ratio. You will see there is part 1 of the top coat A measured out. It is a 2-to-1 mix ratio, and there goes the second measurement of top coat A, and we are measuring out approximately 750 milliliters of it at a time. So there's two parts top coat A, and now we will add one part of the curing agent, the top coat part B. And we then have a 2-to-1 mix ratio. The reason that we don't add together the two buckets is that we will have too much for one layer. So we need to measure out in this quantity so we can complete one layer only with the quantity that we have prepared. And one can expect to cover approximately 12 to 13 square meters per liter of mixed product. Mix the top coat thoroughly for approximately 5 minutes, and we will now revert back to the first pool in this video where we will be applying the light blue. Extension pulse to help ease the job a bit. That is the next day. The coating is now hard and set, a little bit glossy, still patchy, but we can clean that now if there's leaves or rainwater or anything in the pool, and then start with the sanding of the whole surface, and that is important, using 60 grit sandpaper to break the gloss. Just scratch it a bit to create a good mechanical bond for the next layer. This is the longer process where we let the coating to dry overnight. Sand it and then
proceed with the next top coat layer. And you will now see how the color will start to come out very solid. You can apply more thickly now on this sanded layer. Again, be careful for teardrops. And there's the finished result after the second coat, and of course the same procedure is followed. Leave it to dry overnight, sand it a bit the next day to break the gloss, and apply the final coat. And this is the final result of that. Before we proceed to the rest of these videos, let's quickly just have a look at a few important points. First of all, these videos are not complete. They are not that detailed. It's a short overview of the process, so you can see what lies ahead and get a feeling for the project. But always read and follow the written application instructions, which is very complete, and that is always rule one. Read the instructions. Right, let's look at the next point. Mix the epoxy A and B components in small quantities. Beware that the product has a pot life. It's an epoxy, so there's a resin and a curing agent that will react with each other, and it will set in the bucket. During winter times and lower temperatures, there's a dramatic increase in pot life, and it can be 1 hour or more. That's why the next point is also important. Keep the components cool. So when you store these components next to the swimming pool or wherever you are working, keep it in the shadow or under roof, and keep it as cool as possible. Also, it helps to paint early in the morning. It's much better. The swimming pool surface is cooler to work on. It will give you a little bit more time to work. And also, when you mix the components and the part A and part B components are not that warm, it will extend the lifespan of the product in the bucket, while when applicated on the swimming pool surface, of course the drying time on the surface will be much longer, in the region of 4 to 6 hours to dry completely. In very hot conditions, of course you might even consider using a large bucket with ice and put the buckets with the components in there. Keep it cool so that when you mix the components together, it will extend the pot life dramatically. We had cases where the product did set in the bucket and people added all the epoxies together, not working in small quantities, and they got a nice mold out of that bucket, which is unusable. Of course, you can use it as a door stopper or a small chair for children, and you will be the only person with such a unique, wonderful object, but it won't help your pool project. So yes, keep in mind the pot life and keeping the components cool. Right, never paint over wet and damp areas in the pool. When you've emptied the pool and you started grinding and sanding, watch out for moist penetrating from the outside, causing wet spots on the pool. Allow these to dry completely. If there's a continuous flow of moist out of certain spots on the surface, it's not on all pools that we do experience this, but there is a percentage of pools which do suffer this condition, where there's high levels of water around the pool and it penetrates through cracks and the surface material. You need to open this up, grind it open, or drill a hole right through the swimming pool side at the bottom of these wet spots, and just drain that water table a bit on the outside before you paint the pool over those areas. Do not paint on brittle or weak substrates. In many cases where the marbleite has become brittle or soft, the epoxy will penetrate that substrate and create a hardened layer inside the substrate, and it might later crack loose when the marbleite is not strong or hard, and you don't want that. So sandy surfaces cannot be painted. Your plaster surface must be hard and solid and able to sustain a painted layer. Of course, the epoxy paint do set into a very hard, glossy, almost a porcelain-like finish. You can't scratch it, you can't remove it by itself, But if it breaks loose from the surface, it will normally be because there is a weak marbleite or plastered surface behind, and 2 or 3 millimeter of that sandy surface will break loose with the epoxy paint layer. And then of course mix the correct components, part A and part B of the epoxy, part A being the resin and part B the curing agent. And of course you have two products in the set that we supply. There is a top coat part A and B, and there's a primer. And of course top coat A is always mixed with top coat B, and mix in the right quantities, and the mixing ratio is indicated in our application instructions and on the buckets. Make sure that you separate the top coat from the primer when you start the project. Start with the primer, put the top coat aside so there's no accidents mixing wrong components together. Then of course a good point, stir the part A components separately before mixing with the curing agent, the part B. It's a good thing to always stir up the pigments, the solvents, mix it in well in the bucket that we supply, or in a separate bucket, but do stir the part A that contains the pigments and the solvents and a lot of quartz that's in there. Just stir it up and keep a good mix throughout the project so your product stays the same and the color stays the same throughout the paint project. Always sand any dried and hardened layers before overcoating. Important point, the epoxy will set into a very glossy surface once it dried overnight, and the coatings to follow will not stick well to it. Just break that gloss a bit, scratch the gloss a bit. It's not important to sand that deep on it, but it must be sanded everywhere. Don't skip spots, as that might compromise the interlayer bonding of the product. If you follow the short method where the epoxy coat is applied in while it's still damp and wet, of course you don't have to sand in between. We hope you enjoyed this, and we will soon have more videos for you to watch.